I mean, growing up, for me personally, something that I always thought that a man was, I always looked at my dad as what a man should be like. Just being in the house, like, and that being the immediate person that's in my life, that's a man, the male figure. Everything that he does, I feel like I always had to emulate or try to be like that, because that's what I knew what a man was. Does anybody else feel that way?
Like I said, I mean, I totally agree with you. Like, you know, your father cannot have a job and be in the house. And that means more than, you know, just a father that picks you up on the weekend and give you everything that you want. So I totally agree with you.
You guys think in today's society there's an absence of men? Why is that?
Because if everybody, including the male, is not ready to be set up to both as a man, you're never born a man or a woman. At some point, you mature into those things. And everybody is not willing to step up to the plate to become and mature into those things in the areas that they were to mature in.
At what point in, I guess, in a male's life, do you think that happens? Do you think they transition into manhood?
I think high school.
High school. Yeah. Why high school?
Because you're at that point where you kind of finding yourself. And it's easy to get sidetracked in high school. You know, like from middle school to high school, you know, some of your friends, they change, like, either for the better or for the worse. Like, that's like the right time to catch them and kind of mold them into, you know, how their future is going to turn out.
That's interesting. You guys know, like, in movies and stuff about history, like 300 and stuff, there's always a certain point where they have to do like a rite of passage into manhood, like they have to survive in the wilderness for a week or something like that. Obviously, it's not like that today, at least in America. But do you guys think there's a form, like there's a type of rite of passage that we have within our culture that tells other people that I'm not a boy anymore?
You can kind of say after like high school, because like when you graduate, you're like, oh, what do I do now? Have to go out on your own, figure out your own path.
Yeah, you have to. It's really like pretty much everything after high school. It is just the rest of your life is just you're proving that you're a man, really. Just like everything's a test, everything's a new hurdle that you have to pass. Because after high school, it's like you're out on your own. It's you against the world. That's pretty much it.
I say prioritizing. I think prioritizing, it shows what you put first shows a lot about you. You know, you might put God first, then your family, then school, then whatever. I think whatever you prioritize first, such as partying rather than going to the library till 11 o'clock to study, you know, those two things are, I think that's
big. I agree with her. Like, my father died when I was young. So my brother, like, they always say you're supposed to take that role as a man. Like, he's like, you're the man now. Like, although he was young, he was like 13. He still had to prioritize. Like, you have brothers and sisters, now you're supposed to help your mom. So I think that really made him a man. Like, although he was an adolescent, he still took on that role as a man. So.
Are there any, like, figures, whether it's fictional characters or real people, that when you think of this guy, kind of like she said in the video, like Tyrese, when you think of this person, you think that's a man. Mm-hmm. What would you guys say?
I said a rock. Yeah, especially if they like in all the movies, you know, what's the one? Big Stick? Is that what it's called?
Big Walk Tall.
Walk Tall. He got a big stick in the movie, that's what happened. Yeah. Because like in that movie, he's so gung-ho on taking care of his family and protecting them that he's willing to put himself in, he's willing to put himself in danger as long as he can take care and protect the ones he's loved. That's what I feel like a man is supposed to do. At some point in time, you're supposed to be like, okay, I no longer matter. It's the people I love, the people I care about the most.
I think somebody too, Also, well, I say, there was this line that J. Cole said, and I thought about it, and it was real, though, because he said, rest in peace one time, Uncle Phil, for real, you the only father that I ever knew. Right? And like, and when I think about it personally, like, I think Uncle Phil was actually a good father figure. Like, he was a success, he was a judge, he was living nice, but also he put his foot down when he needed to. He took in his nephew who, you know, for one reason or another had to come stay with him. You feel what I'm saying? So I think Uncle Phil was the greatest.
That's okay, right? What does a man look like? Like physical features?
It doesn't matter.
Okay. Nicole, I see. You gotta speak. I think a man should be somewhat physically imposing. Because, you know, we say he's supposed to be a protector and things like that. You have to be able to protect somebody. whether it's being big, whether it's being mentally strong, physically strong, whatever the case may be. I don't think your woman should have to fight your marriage. Or your kids should run you if they're scared. I mean, run your woman if they're scared. So, personally, what I think of a man, whether or not I'm right, I think it's somebody who is somewhat muscular, somewhat big, somewhat knows how to protect themselves. You know, personally.
So you're saying someone who's not built can't protect their child?
Not necessarily.
Like they know martial arts or something, but that means they can't. I know someone who's not built at all, and he knows martial arts, and he probably takes down unless he's a statue. Does that make him not a man because he's not muscular?
Probably so, but I'm just saying that's what I think of when I visualize a man. I'm not saying you have to be that to be a man. But, you know, when I think of man, I think of like a quiet confidence. So not necessarily somebody who's walking around here beating everybody's ass, but, you know, just somebody that, by their demeanor, by the way they carry themselves, you can tell, you know, let me respect myself, too. Let me not, you know, mess with them the same thing, you know, derogatory towards them. But that's what I think of. Does anybody disagree with that?
Oh, no, I'm just saying I disagree with
it. You disagree with it? Why?
I'm sorry,
because I don't think your physical appearance, it's like judging a book by its cover. I know small frame, tiny people that would fight way quicker than the biggest person in the room that would hold down their family or whoever. Me, I'm 5'7". I wouldn't back down for someone 6'4". I don't know, it makes me a man or stupid. But my physical feature, nothing can do with it. Like, man, you're not going to punk me. Nobody's going to. My dad is the same way. He's 5'6". I'm taller than him. You're not going to punk him. Nobody's going to punk him. You know, I don't think that makes you a man. Because you, I don't know, because you're bigger than somebody. Or you look aggressive. Or you carry yourself with confidence. Like, don't let anything happen.
Your physical appearance is what makes you a man, you know what I'm saying? I feel like a man is a man of heart, a mind, you know, isn't it? The way you look does not mean you're a man. You could have muscle but still have a good wound.
Very good.
I agree and disagree with you. Like, I don't think he was saying that every man is supposed to be muscular and built. It's just like the first thing. Like, that's just the first thing you think of physically when somebody says the word man. You think of somebody who's bigger or whatever. But, like you said, like, if somebody who in some type of way has posted a slight purity, whether it's because they're fit, because they're physically, mentally, or something, it's something about them that you just know, like, I don't know, it's just, like, if I ain't scared of none of y'all in here for some type of reason, it's a problem. I'm probably scared of everybody in here from some type of reason. I ain't gonna let y'all bitch me, but it's something about everybody that everybody carries, a man or a woman, that it's something about them that other people know, you know, maybe they're about their shit. Like, it's just a little bit. It might not be your physical attribute, but it's your mental attribute.
agree with him. What's your name?
Ace.
Okay, I agree with Ace because a man, you just can't go off of physical features because we have a lot of people that now are not born a man, but they are men. So if you go off a physical feature and you see that person, they're probably born a woman, but with a sex change, they look like a man. So I think that is more than your physical features. It's about taking care of your family, setting a good example, being a role model, and providing. Not necessarily being built, because you can be built and not be proud. And be at house with no job and not contribute to anything. So it's just more than how you look.
Very good. Not take sides, but I look at like your physical attributes as well as an asset. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's like a benefit for you or like an advantage. But other than that, like, I agree with him. Like, it's not going to make you a man. You just, you know what I'm saying?
What does a man dress like? When you think of man, what comes to mind?
Not savvy.
The question I have is like, what age group are you talking about? Like,
you think
what age group would have a difference? It would make a difference in how they dress because it would make a difference in how they look at things mentally.
But I think mentally, it's when you change mentally that makes you a man or a woman. So it's not really an age group because, like she said, her brother took on the role of the man in the house when he was 13 years old. Like. Right. He might have dressed a certain way, but it's his mentality that made him a man.
Right, well, man, his mentality changed, but I'm pretty sure he still dressed like a teenager, right?
Yeah, okay.
Like, based
off
your age, you
want to
dress the way the trend is.
Right, right.
No, I'm saying just like, just superficially, like, what do you think of man? Do you think business suit? Do you think work boots?
I think it's like down the middle for me. It's either you're clean cut, you know, you got yourself together, whether it's for a Sunday, for church, or for your job. Or if you got a little bit of dirt under your fingers, it's because you out there grinding, you know. Or if you got something on your knees, it's because you out there grinding, you know. You're getting dirty, trying to make money. That's the thing.
No, man, it's just like, you can't. See, the problem is with this is like we're trying to put like men and women into two small categories, like in a box. And it's like it's hard to define men and women into this small box because anything women can do, men can do, and vice versa.
That's biological.
I'm not talking about that. Because when you look at it, what really defines a man is what I've been hearing is responsibility. And we can take responsibility too.
That's what makes her a woman.
Makes a man a man.
But you also have to take in the biological aspect of it because we're not the same biological.
Yeah, yeah.
So that's another thing.
That's the only thing that separates us.
But you still have to take it into account when you see me.
Just say,
like, what a woman can do, a man can do,
a
woman can do.
But I don't believe in that statement that a man can do, a man can do. I don't believe in that statement. I feel like God has created a man for some purpose and a woman for some purpose. So the moment a woman starts to do what a man does, there's a problem somewhere in there. I can't do what a man can do because I'm not a woman. And I don't want to do what a man does because I'm not a woman. So saying that what a man can do, what a man can do, she might do the same thing, but there will be a slight difference. You know what I'm saying? If I put on, if I give you her clothes to wear, for example, no, if I give you her clothes to wear, you have to go. You have to go. Even those guys that come, that those Americans that change their sex to, ask my God. Their hands are big, you know, there's a man, but their ass is a woman. You can undergo any kind of surgery, that was too big. But this is a man.
Go ahead.
Well, I think that a woman can be a man. Because coming from a single parent home, I was taught you take care of yourself, you don't need a man for this, you don't need a man for this. I see my mom taking out the trash, going along with it. That's a man's job, right? So,
but in the same aspect, your mom can't teach you, as a female, your mom can't really teach you what a man is.
What to expect.
Like, your mom can definitely tell you, don't take this from a man, don't find a man like this or whatever. She can help you learn from her mistakes, but as a female, she can't directly tell you how to be a male, just like she wouldn't be able to teach if you had a brother. She can't teach your brother how to be a man because she's a female.
You raise your hand, Rob? All right, my next question is, you know how people say, I want to find a good man, I want to be a good man, I want to be this kind of man or that kind of man. What is our definition of a good man? Like, what does it mean? What differentiates an average nigga and a good man? What do you think separates him? Like, what's that one thing or two things that makes a good man stand out?
Because the mindset of an average nigga, I feel like that mindset is just get it now and don't worry about later. As long as you're good for now, you don't have to worry about later. Whereas a man, his mindset is if you get it now, you need to make sure you have it, then you can sustain it till later. Like, an average nigga, he's gonna hustle or grind to get to a certain point, but at some point, he's not gonna get it to sustain himself anymore. So he's gonna go back out to that millionaire thing. He's gonna get to a point where he knows he's comfortable and he can sustain the lifestyle that he's living without having to compromise himself and his own. Whereas anybody else, like, all right, if I'm going to eat this, then I got to do this. A man would know at some point, like, if he knows he can't sustain himself past right now a working lifestyle, then he's not going to try to go past a working lifestyle because he knows that's not sustainable.
So,
are we talking about just black men or any men?
Exactly. Yeah. What men is done.
Yeah. What do you think the difference is?
Because I've dated a white guy. And I think that their approach is totally different than a black man's approach. Their style of raising, of course, is different. So, you said, when you say, what is a good man? It seems like we're putting it into, like, categories of a black man. Exactly. Right.
They can measure your
Yeah, that's what I meant. Do you think there's a difference between black manhood and white manhood?
It shouldn't be. I feel like a guy, an average guy, as opposed to an average nigga, because it's not just, you know, but an average guy has a singular approach to life. He is, right now, I'm thinking about my money, my this, my that, as opposed to a man has a very, global kind of appeal, and yeah, it's just broad. His perspective on life is broad. He's concerned with himself, you know, better himself, his family, his community, you know, things like that. So he's thinking about the future. I don't know if you said that, but and an average guy is thinking about the right now, the hustle right now, as opposed to sustainability, you know, for long term. So a real man is thinking about providing and planning and protecting his family and anyone in his community.
And that's regardless of race.
That's regardless.
And I didn't want to use the average nigga thing, but I just couldn't figure out what
I got you. I just wanted to.
I appreciate it.
Yeah. You're wrong.
Okay.
But can I ask a question?
Yeah.
What's the differences that you saw in white manhood versus black manhood?
I'm not going to say manhood. I'm just talking about as far as their approach with dating. I saw differences.
What
differences?
The difference, how he approached me was very different. He actually approached me with his business card and asked to take me on a date. He asked for my first and last name. So it's just versus when you see most black guys who are trying to talk to people like, hey, little mama, can I holler at you real quick? Or show me the blue.
Well, you said most
black.
And it should be a line that why.
Yeah, I'm not saying all of them.
So learn to give her what she's used to, so she gives you a little bit of her time. And then, exactly. Because the first thing that you can make a mistake, I woke up with girls who I thought like something don't care about me, but I put them the right way, they want to get close. And then when they got to know me, like, they want to accept it for the
years. I'm used to guys coming up, hey, mom, what's your name? Hey. No, you, like she said, you sound like you don't know your alphabet. Like you stumped on the letter A, like you didn't go to kindergarten and you can't get past A. I'd rather you approach me with, hey, how you doing? My name is so-and-so, can I get your name? Because even though that's not what I'm used to, it's what I respect. So I feel like when you said you should kind of like stereotype a girl and stuff, how you approach her, I feel like you should do that. You should approach everybody in the same manner. Like, but I'm going to approach anybody no matter where they're from. I'm not going to change who I am. That's what I'm saying. Because when you're stereotyping somebody and approaching them in a different manner, you're changing you. So I'm not going to change who I am just because of who you are. Deidre's going to be Deidre 100% of the time. So why not approach me like Uzi rather than approaching me like the dude that just approached me before?
I think something I'm observing is the fact that in our society, there is a lack of men, lack of males. It's almost a hard pill to swallow. Like, I feel like if the average girl was approached by a man, she wouldn't know how to handle it. And she would most likely push him away rather than accept it. Because unfortunately, there's a lack of fathers. There's a lack of leaders, male leaders. There's a lack of people that we can say, okay, this guy's responsible, this guy's what a man should be. So whenever you approach what a man should be, or whether it's a friend, whether it's somebody who's trying to talk to you, whatever the case may be, you're more going to be like, than accept it. And that's what the problem is. So there is a lack of men, and there's a lack of appreciation for men. That's what I think. Let's transition into women. What is a woman? What is a woman? When you think woman, who comes to mind? What comes to mind?
A lot of dudes don't know how to really see a woman for what she really is, in a way. And women kind of get judged based kind of like on your actions. I'm not going to approach a girl in a way that I would come at a woman. It's not gonna happen. But the reason why I say women are life is because, like, there's a lot of guys that beat on women. There's a lot of guys that kind of like mistreat them in certain ways. But when I say that they're life, like, we all started from that. Like, we all came from that. Like, how do you feel mistreating something that, it's so precious, and, you know, like, we see kind of, like, girls, like, you know, getting using themselves for other stuff, and then, like, they want a certain amount of respect from us. Like, how do you expect me to treat you like life if you're not treating yourself like you're as precious as life yourself? Like, I don't get it, but you want me to give you that respect.
So it sounds like what you're saying is, it almost sounds like you're saying a woman is somebody who reminds you of your mom.
I mean, it's not even just my mother. It's just life in general. Because if you think about it, mother nature, it's like everything is kind of like surrounded by women, because they're life bringers, they're life givers, they're creators. You know what I'm saying? So like, we can't get anywhere without women. Period. If a dude was mad angry and was like, man, for some reason I just hate women, I wish they were gone, bro, you would be gone and none of us would exist. Not even the stuff that women have done throughout history, but in general, being life givers, like, that's so important, and we overlook that every single day about women. But
go ahead, Uzi, and then go.
But it depends on the woman. Some give life, some take life. Some give you life, some take life. So you have to find out the one that gives you, like, not all women are given by it, honestly. I would say this modern generation, 80% of men take life from them. 80% take life from them. And the rest 20 give life. So the moment you find out a good woman, see, it's a better procedure. You find out a good woman, then you capitalize on her. But a lot of females are weak.
You say capitalize.
They're weak. So it's not a woman that gives you life.
I agree.
Then for me, you know, I wouldn't, you know, I would have to take my time and, you know, recognize what is a nice woman. A nice woman is not a hair, shoe, maybe she's not an ethnic.
When you guys are saying give life, do you mean in the biological sense or in the sense that you're pooping somebody's life, like making a house a home type of life?
I mean, same. There's going to be, I mean, of course we have like the base biological one, but like, you know, there's women that step up to that role of like, well, look, I'm going to make sure that I'm going to do everything I can for my kids, regardless. I have to have respect for that. I have to approach you with a certain amount of respect. I'm not going to disrespect you in no type of way to be like, okay, you a single, I know for a fact that you're a single mom, you got 5 kids, but I'm thinking about trying to get some J's from you. I'm not going to do that. It's a certain, you know, respect type thing. You can't do that to someone who's trying to be her best as a mother. It's just an example, I'm not, you know, saying like that, but, yeah.
What is it?
I agree with what my man said and what Darius said earlier. As far as women giving life, and Darius said, anything, you know, a woman can do, you know, a man can do besides, you know, give birth and all this stuff. Because, you know, a woman can give life, but, you know, it takes a man to help give life. A woman can't just have a baby, you know what I'm saying, by herself. She has to take a man. And earlier, since we're saying women give a life, you know, what I believe, a woman came from Adam's rib, knowing that without Adam's rib, he wouldn't be Adam. He would be done. So he gave equal responsibility to the man and the woman. So, like I said, like he said, a woman can get, she can do the same thing a man can do. So when we say what a woman is, just about everything you say, a man can do. Just about everything a man can do, a woman can do. That's how I feel about it.
But I feel like I'm not saying one is more important than the other, but and women are special in their own right. But it's something about a man that is very important. Like, there's a reason why, I'm gonna just put it this way, since you talk about the Bible, it's a reason why Jesus referred to God as his father and not his mother. You get what I'm saying? Because there's an important role that a man plays. I'm not saying that everybody has a different role. I'm not saying one is more important than the other, but I feel like I don't think that everything a man can do, a woman can do, and vice versa. But
I feel what you're saying when you say, like, the father thing. The reason, like, I think the reason why I said the woman thing in life is because we kind of, well, me personally, I kind of know that about the father and, you know, the importance of a man. Like, that's kind of, like, instilled in me. I know that. But with women, we kind of don't really know how important they really are, or we don't really realize how important they really are to us. So that's why I kind of spoke on that more than the father thing.
All right, like we clearly said earlier, there's a distinction between a male and a man. Is there a distinction between a female and a woman? And if there is, what is that distinction? It's harder to tell, you know, the difference between a boy and a man than it is a girl and a woman.
The woman's not gonna walk with her ass out or out like that, or flaunting this and doing certain things that she shouldn't be doing towards the video and all that kind of stuff. I think it's just as clear to see a guy who carries himself as a man and a guy who carries himself as a boy versus a woman who carries himself as a woman and not being a childish individual. Respecting her body, respecting her person, respecting her kids, whatever it is. If your kids are at your grandmother's house, coming at their grandmother's house 95% of the time, and it's not because you're working or in school, that's not a woman, because you're not even trying to step up to womanhood. You did woman things at woman reaction, and not trying to step up to that woman. And vice versa.
You did woman things at woman reaction.
All right, how do you find a woman? How do you find it? Define a woman.
Well, the woman is, she actually takes before she acts. And if you say, how do I find a woman? Tell my location, right? How do you find something? So you want to write about me, you know? So let's go to my brother.
What is the right word?
Well, I would say some environment gives you more chances of finding a better woman than some environment. So let's say I'm in church.
Well, I'll say that.
That would happen. You should get take a time from the church before you go to the house and go to the house. You can come to that place. Shop, shop.
You think women are at the club?
I met a church girl at the club. She's a Christian teacher. You know, I didn't know. very church girl. I met her at the club. But you could still tell her there's no slight difference. She said, and then she was dreaming for money. And then when we started to talk, she started to cry. and I asked her, what are you crying? She said, somebody from our church saw her.
Very independent, very vocal about what we want and what we need. Whereas in other cultures, they're not told.
like my mom's always told me, never depend on a man for anything. And I guess I took that to the extreme because I don't depend on anybody for anything. I'm a proud person by nature. But when in other cultures, when you're not allowed to do certain things, it's because they're making you depend in a way or whatever. Because taking it back to the Muslim culture, say if a woman wanted to get a divorce from her husband, she could leave, but she wasn't allowed to take her children with her. Nothing that she came in with, nothing that she got while in the marriage or that she came into marriage with is allowed to go back with her if they were to get a divorce. Whereas in American culture, we're expected if two people split up or if two people aren't together, the child automatically goes with the mother unless there's some extenuating circumstances. So it's a lot in culture that changes what womanhood and manhood actually is defined by.
Coming from, you know, a household where both, you know, I had both mom and dad, it depends on the person. Because, I mean, honestly, yeah, my mom said, she said basically you can rely on a man, but don't rely on him for everything.
Yeah.
Like, I mean, you're going to need a man and just as well as a man is going to need a woman. Yeah. So it's like, you know, it'll just depend on the household you came out of. So.
So are definitions based on culture, or is there like a standard that transcends culture? That's just like human, man.
I think certain aspects of each are transcending culture, but a lot of it is based on culture. Like nurturing, we expect that to be in every woman, no matter her culture, race, whatever. Whereas in other things, we don't expect that from everybody, because the culture.
Why do you think, like growing up, boys are told, you know, don't cry, be a man, you know, be tough, things like that. Do you guys agree with things like that, or do you think those are outdated ideals? Or do you think it's a reason?
I kind of agree.
Oh, man. Man.
It's okay for a man
to
look at it.
I just feel like I'm not saying a man shouldn't get to cry. I'm a man. I feel like a man. I know I cry. My grandmother died. I cried. I had a bad breakup and I mean shed a tear. That's real. But I do agree with the theory of it. I agree that if we're supposed to be like you said, the protector, the provider. We shouldn't be as emotionally tied up and kind of have that front as the protector, or we can't show that weakness or that vulnerability, you know, over us who are taking advantage of, whether that's by women who will take advantage of your vulnerability, or a man would punk you because he knows that you're weaker. So I do agree with the theory of it. Not saying complete, oh no, you can't cry, you cry, you're not a man.
Right. I want to agree with that too, like man's the, like, like for instance, like if it was a married couple and your wife just lost her job and she crying, she'll need you crying too. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
You know, she needs to be there. Or vice versa, like if you know what I'm saying, if you a man and you crying because you lost your job, you'll need your wife crying too. You need her, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
so you know what I'm saying? So touche.
Very good. You guys name
it. I guess I agree with him. Like it's a vulnerability. It's not the fact that you're crying. It's a vulnerability and so-called weakness that is shown when a male cries. That's why I have no problem with a guy crying. I like to see a guy cry, shed a tear too. Don't ask me why. I just like it. But it's the vulnerability, when people say be a man, don't cry, it's the vulnerability that you're showing, it's that weakness. Because people will always mistake something about you for a weakness, whether it's because you're too nice or because you cried in public that one time. It's going to follow you forever, so that weakness is what people are going to take in. But it's always said, like, if you're going to cry, if you're a man, you cry behind closed doors. Well, sometimes you can't make it behind those closed doors. You know what I mean? So it's like, it happens. You're human before you're a man. You're human.
I mean, you know, I agree what she said, but to me, you know, I have a different perspective of life. You know. I think crying is not even a sign of weakness for me. Even the Bible says, cry out loud. You know, it's like when you're hurt, you cry, right? When something goes wrong, you cry. But when you cry, that's the best thing to do at that moment. Then after crying, you wipe your tears, then you start with a solution. I don't cry and end up with a solution. I'm not crying, I don't know nothing about it. So when you quantify or qualify cry with weakness, it's an expression of emotions.
Yeah. Now, I don't want to mistake
it.
I don't think crying is a sign of weakness.
It's
just what society
is. It is the exact issue. So when I cry, he's weak. No. Dude, if something happens, I'm going to cry all day. All day long. Until I'm tired of crying and I fall asleep. Then when you wake up, you say, okay, I can't cry no more. No tears again. What can I do again? I can't cry no more. So what's the solution? When you begin to work on yourself.
Is there a problem with feminine guys?
Snatch it out of my hand.
Right. You feel me?
Like,
yeah, let you be that.
Exactly.
There was a girl, she said that a woman has to know how to let a man be a man.
Yeah.
So we all agree that's a part of what, what does that mean to let a man be a man?
Wait, what?
What does it mean to let a man be a man? Because you know, these days there are a lot of women who emasculate men by different things. You know, they worry about the fact
that I don't know what that means.
In space, they worry about the fact that they don't need them in space. You know, things like that. So what does it mean to let a man be a man? Or vice versa, let a woman be a man? What does that mean?
Does the same thing that every woman wants to be told, you're beautiful today, you got your hair good, I love that dress on you, I look boom boom down. They want us. They might say they don't want it. They love it. They might not even say thank you, but they love it. We are also the type that kind of needs our ego stroked every now and then. Like, let me feel like, yeah, I open this job. let me be a provider.
I was gonna say letting a man be a man to me means allowing him to lead, make decisions. Like, if he's going to open a car door, don't say, I got it. No, you got it. You good. I can take out the trash when you're not there, but, you know, I'm able to do it on my own. So I feel like letting a man run the household and you being there, like, his backbone to support him and all those things. I think that's what letting a man be a man.
Anybody disagree with that?
No.
Yes.
I think letting a man be a man, you know, won't be a woman breaks down to let just somebody be herself, because there's not going to be that one defining characteristic for every single person. You're like, oh, she's a woman because of this, or he's a man because of that. It goes back to what she says. Before they were a man or a woman, they were a boy or a girl. Before they were even a boy or a girl, they were just a human. It just goes all the way back to how do you define it.
I agree with that. I want to go back to the situation they were talking about. It comes to a point where it can go kind of too far. Where like, oh, you like, let me open this jar of pickles. Okay, I feel like a man. Now that I don't need to open every jar of pickles ever for you. You can do it sometimes too. It comes to a point where like a woman has to be like, I can do some things too. You ain't got to do everything for me.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Do y'all feel like a guy has to pay for dinner?
Hell no.
I'm going to always carry cash on me or something on me where I can pay myself. But yeah, if he asked, then yeah, he should. Because it was his idea. Now, if I'm just like, hey, let's go out or whatever, or if we just come to an agreement that we're just going somewhere, then I can expect to pay for myself. If he happens to pay for me, cool. You know, no money out of my pocket. But if not, I'm not.
I was just gonna say some men Alan was talking about maybe like two, three weeks ago. We talked about like, you know, as a guy, like you might look and see like is she expecting me to pay for it? Or if, like, you kind of want to see, like, for instance, if you go out and you, like, you in your mind, you already know you're going to pay for it, but if she don't even reach for her pocket, like, she can reach for her pocket and then you decline it, like, nah, you know, I got it. But if she don't even reach for that pocket, then you know what's up.
Okay, I decline all that because I feel like if it's like a first date type thing, as a man, I wouldn't be really playing no games like that in that area on the first date. I'm automatically, by default, it's set in my head, I'm paying for everything.
Oh, we're paying for it regardless.
No, I'm not making no moves to wait and see. I'm gonna take care of everything with no games or no...
You know
what I'm saying? Do you understand what I'm talking about? Yeah, like, I get what you're saying, to see what she's gonna do, to see her reaction is cool, but on the first date, I'm automatically by default, like before she even tried to, when the bill comes on the table, ma'am, can you just hand it to me? You ain't got to put it on the table.
Cause I know some girls who will reach in their pocket and know they don't have nothing in their pocket at all. Like I'll be like,
and if I wait, and if I wait, you embarrassed, right? If I wait, you embarrassed. Oh, you got it. Oh, okay.
I don't care if you're not at the age, you know, I'm just gonna keep it real, because I keep it real all the time.
Keep it real.
All I want from a girl is respect me, look nice, shopping, eating food on my bill. I pay everything.
Show me that you're able to help me as well. Your benefits in my life as well, not just me getting what's all done.
So show that she can give life just like you can give life.
That's how it was for give life.
So this is for the men, like how do y'all feel when the women actually assume your role? Like paying for the meals, doing like
she should assume.
She basically taking you out.
She does it all the time, so you should already feel some type of way that you're not doing your job.
Exactly. Yeah. But I'm asking the men.
Oh,
I'm asking the men.
I need clarity. We should pay for the meals. We should like hold the door open and stuff like that. Should we? Like, how do you feel if a woman did that?
That's weird. It depends. Well, hold on the door. No man holding the door to me is weird.
I'll say this. If she does it all the time, it's weird. But if she does it like once, for example, you know, I find it cute. I find it like, okay, she's not just with me because I'm a man and what I'm doing for her. It's, you know, she genuinely wants to be with me. If the roles were reversed, I was the woman, she was a man, she would take care of me just the same. But as far as doing it all the time, that's a masculine. That's like, wow.
Yeah. So like on Instagram, this for the lady, since you had a question for the males. Yeah. If you were on the first date and the boy was supposed to pay and his one card did not work, would you pay for both of y'all or would you just pay for your meal and
y'all don't think this is funny, but we're gonna have to reassess the situation. If your card is declined, we're gonna sit there and just think for a second. Okay? I'm gonna be like, you know, first off, I'm gonna be like, you got another card.
Okay. Well, you wanna go to the dishes.
You know, like, do you have another card? Because I might not. But I mean,
but this is his only card.
You should have chose me.
His only card.
Well, he had no money.
I mean, it depends
on how I'm getting it. No. This
is
your. Yeah, I'm gonna get your card. I'm gonna say, okay, Sam, he's expecting something more. Maybe he was expecting more than what he had. You know, so I'll give you the benefit of the doubt first time. Cool, I'll pay for it. Because I'm not gonna sit there and let you. Like, because the mailbox already took some type of way, because y'all on the first date, and his car getting declined, he already feels some type of way, so I'm not going to further emasculate him. So, I would go on that second date with you, but if that second date, the same thing happened, and I see the pattern, there's a problem. If by the second date, your car is still getting declined, let's go to the second date, let's talk to them about it. Let's figure out what the real problem is.
So, back to what he was saying earlier about like opening all the jars or pickles or whatever. Do y'all feel belittled when a man does everything for you? Man, he's trying not to let you do anything.
Yes.
Else?
Yes.
Especially if you used to be independent.
You need
to question your woman, but if a man can do everything for you,
no,
that's the problem. That's the problem. Especially if a man can do everything for you, like you need to question your womanhood, because once he walk away from you, what you gonna do?
Amen.
What you gonna, how you gonna figure out how you
get from there? Everything.
Exactly.
I feel like a woman's job for her man, when you have that role for a man, like, it's serious. Like, if you know you got a good one, why not cook for him? Why not have his meals ready for him?
She's saying, like, I'm speaking from a guy's perspective, not from a girl's perspective, but like, I feel like, because I've noticed this transition in myself, I can't say I'm all the way the most manliest of all men yet. I can't say that because it's a process. We still college students. What I'm saying is this, like, I noticed this transition in myself, like, a boy will appreciate you just for your looks. And that's it. Like that's as far as it goes. But a man will appreciate your qualities. You feel me? Like that's something I noticed in myself. Like back in the day, like I used to be all like, man, look, she got fat ass. And I would still do that up to this day. But now it's about qualities. It's more about what you bring to my life. Can I learn something from you? if I can't learn from you, then why, you know what I'm saying? So I feel like that's a big difference as well.
I think when she said catering to your man, like, I feel like it's a two-way street, it's a 50-50 thing.
It is.
Like, I'm not going to be sitting here doing everything for you if you're not
sitting
there. Okay, that's a lie.
It's your mom.
That's the one thing. I didn't hurt the world. Yeah,
I feel like as a man, like how you said it was like it's a 50-50 thing when she was talking about catering. Okay, like as a man, I think that 50 that we bring is default. Like as a man, because we're supposed to. You know what I'm saying? We're not. I guess, trying. If you're in a relationship, you're not really trying to become a man in that process. You should by then be closer to a man stage than a boy if you're getting into a relationship. So when you're bringing that 50% that you do bring, when you say it's a half and half, if the girl's gonna cater to me and treat me right like that, like, I'm gonna automatically be a man. I should deserve that in a way, a little bit. Because I'm going to be a man regardless. I'm not going to be less than what I'm going to give you. So I think I deserve a little catering here and
there. I don't like the term cater. I think a better way to say it is that a woman should make a man's life should bring peace. should bring peace to a man's life. And cooking, you know, as overlooked as that is a way to do that. Because, I mean, we can both cook. Chances are you cook a lot better than me.
I kind of understand where you're coming from when you say you should make the guy's life easier, because in a way, like, it's already hard for you guys. You're already out there in the real world. You're a black man and you're trying to work and you're trying to do your thing. So it shouldn't just be the female like going on and on about her day, but to ask her man about how your day was or how is your job treating you or what is it that I can do. Like, make sure your kids are in bed at a decent hour. Make sure your meal is cooked. Like, I'm not saying rub his feet or make sure that you do the job of his mom. And have the clothes folded and just the other things and have the house kept up. I'm not saying I'm going to.
But would you expect that from a woman who works the same amount of hours as a guy? Because if we're both working, if we both have a busy schedule, if we both have a working schedule,
you're gonna hire
a manager. But how you were saying it was making it seem like if the woman was a stay-at-home wife, a stay-at-home mom.
Oh no,
that's
not
for every woman.
But even if you have a busy schedule, I feel like as a female, you learned this as a kid, or at least I have. You keep that household up. I don't care what you got going on in your life.
I do agree with you, but to say that I'm supposed to do all
by yourself. Mom, you're supposed to do all by yourself, because when you have a man, your household, your man is going to take care of you. Regardless, he's going to make sure that he helps you just as much as you help his household. But at the same time, I'm not going to sit here and be like, I'm going to do this 24/7, because I have aspirations of being CEO in my own law firm. So I'm not going to sit here and say,
yes,
well, I'm not going to say that I'm going to take care of my household, making sure that everything is good for your mom to come. That's not going to happen. But what I can say is I'm going to make sure that you're fed. I'm going to tell you that you will have lunch packed for you in the morning. Wow. But I can say that you're so wrong.
What's your name?
To take some of the pressure off women, I think, now some guys are different, but I think most guys are more concerned with the question, not can you cook, but will you cook? You feel what I'm saying? They're more concerned with the question, not can you cook, but will you cook? You get what I'm saying? Because we are nobody, you know. So I feel like that's a big deal. Like, will you cook? At least for me, will you?
Okay, I'm not going out though. Yeah, I'm actually going to cook. But you won't realize there will be TV dinners. There will be us going out. There will be ramen dinners. If you were struggling, I'm cooking for you. I'm cooking for you. Okay, I want some more.
Yeah, you can
tell us
all. If you can buy it, I'll cook it.
There
got to be some give and take here. Because I ain't buying it and taking the shit. No. Somebody
got to do something. No, no, no. No, no. No, no. As a female, when you start talking to a guy, or when you start dating a guy, like, does he have to ask you to group up or volunteer? Why are you asking me that?
See.
Because most oftentimes, it's the guy that always looking at, can you cook? Can you cook this?
Because it's always helpful
to
have niggas
cook too. So, what is it?
Yes,
good
if
a
boy can cook.
Speak loud.
I can't say it's always good if a man can cook too, because you don't want to do it all by yourself.
I think our point is if you're driving down the road with your man and the car breaks down.
So, do you feel any different if the man, when y'all do make that stop, do he get out the car and change the tire, or try to call someone?
Just take care of the situation. I'm just not having a man to handle the situation. You feel me? Like, I had a homegirl, I went to her house, and her man felt the need to just sit on the couch while she washed the dishes, didn't want to help her dry, anything like that. And I looked at him and I was like, oh, so you're not going to get up? And he was like, nah, she got it. That's a problem for me. Because when you're always in the household and you're always cooking and cleaning and your man don't want to help you.
And that's the point I'm trying to get to. He should be willing to help at some point. I'm not saying you have to do everything. But I'm saying as long as you show me that you're willing to at least help me, then it's fine. I have no problem with it. Because that's what I'm supposed to be.
I think in a partnership, you know, marriage, boyfriend, girlfriend, whatever the case may be, I feel like, you know, we are men and women, but we're both leaders in our own right. And what I mean by that is that it's certain aspects of life that I feel like she should step up and lead. Just like in certain aspects that I should step up and lead, like providing. I should be the leader. We could both provide. You understand? But it's different between the quarterback and the receiver. It's the same thing. it's the same thing with food. I can cook too. But I shouldn't be the leader of the household when it comes to the kitchen. You know what I'm saying? Just like you shouldn't be the leader of the household when it comes to fixing the car. Or making sure our bank statements are balanced and things like that.
So, okay, I have a question. Do guys, I would expect to have to pay half my bills once I'm married, to pay some of my bills. Do guys expect for a female to pay any of the bills?
I don't expect much.
No, I don't.
So, let me know. I'm going to have to pay half my bills.
If you don't
have
to pay half my bills,
My mother cooked, cleaned, and took care of the kids. So it was like coming to bills, my father did all of that. So my mother don't have to do nothing. Okay, she was working, but she wasn't working all day. So when he did need money, she got her backup money that can help him. But when I get married, I'm going to be that woman that my husband pays the bills, I'm going to let him do him. I take care of the kids. It depends how you was raised. If you was raised in a single parent home and your mother did this and that, you're used to that. You was raised to do that. So it depends on how you was raised.
I feel like when you're married, it's not a my bills and your bills. It's our bills. You're a household. You work together for a family. But that's why I feel like, you know, because it's our bills and not just his bills. That's why I feel like I should, even if I'm not paying like the mortgage or the big bills, I feel like I need to contribute.
I don't feel like it matters. Like, I'm paying payment in the mortgage. I've been married 30 years.
What me and Uzi are saying is, African men, we want our wife to work because she wants to, not because she has to.
Right, like my parents have been married 30 years. My mom works, my dad works. They have a joint account. They both have separate accounts as well, but they have a joint account. It's not like, babe, you pay the mortgage and I'll take care of the cable or the lights. We live in this household. We have kids. We have to sustain our family. So yes, she is more of the homemaker, even though she works 40 hours a week because she wants to, you know. He still provides, he still does everything concerning the cars, the lawns, all of that. But when it comes to the financial, he balances the checkbook, he does all that. I even asked her this year, like, mom, did y'all file taxes? I don't know. I don't do that. I have to do that. Your dad does that. So it's not like it's yours and mine. We have to do this as one.
Yeah.
But I feel like if you're dating, that is all irrelevant.
Yeah,
so,
it is.
I mean, like, if you're dating, well, if you're dating, you're not.
I'm not paying. $1,000 a month, he's going to put his $500, she's going to put her $500, because in my situation, my dad died, so my mom had to carry on those responsibilities by herself. If she depended all on my dad, like, he had to pay everything, what she did, she was the mother, like, she did everything that was home, she was a stay-at-home mom. When he died, she had to solely provide for the family. So if she would have had, you know, a job and stuff, she would have been able to do what she could do without him there. So I think she should be able to provide for her home just as much as he should.
Yeah, I think
it should be... Yeah. Like, well, she don't have that mail no more to help her pay.
Exactly. She has to know how to sustain herself.
Right. Just in case in the future I might not be there. So do not abuse that privilege. Just like a woman cooking for you and washing the dish, it doesn't mean on a very tough day, maybe she's not there, but she's so tired and can't do stuff. You should be able to do it, you know, when she's not there. But you don't do it every day. Like, don't abuse that privilege. So when I say a man has to pay the bill, doesn't mean you just relax, sit down, order pizza, eat, watch cable, watch what you do, get back, lose weight, come back and get back. No, you know what I mean? You should be ambitious. Instead of, you know, the money you want to bring to pay the bill, save it. Surprise me. You know what I'm saying? Surprise me with something big and tell me that you want to understand what is going on. That I'm doing doesn't mean I don't want you to spend your money, because I know this is my responsibility.
Okay. I mean, I agree. I'm just saying two individuals should come together and make one. It shouldn't just be one, and then she's just tagging along.
I think personally, if a woman is paying as much as I am as far as bills, it's unbalanced. Because to me, kind of like Jacole said, you can't quantify motherhood. If you're a mother to my kids, that's a job of nothing. You understand me? So to make you pay bills as well, people look at it.
Not making her pay the half. That's not what I'm saying. Not making her pay half. That was just my lifestyle. You don't have to pay half, but she should be contributing to something. Even if it's not just the stuff on the bill or something. She should still contribute to something.
She's actually paying it herself.
A contribute to that household.
That's what motherhood is. The biggest contribution.
Okay, so I have five brothers, and one of my brothers is a lawyer, and his. But he has my niece and my nephew.
Hey, listen.
his sure. whole thing is their mom walked out on my niece and my nephew. And my brother, although he like leaves my niece and my nephew, you know, with one of my other brothers, you know, during the day for when he comes home late at night, he's still able to get up in the morning and like do my niece's hair. He's still able to like make sure that my nephew is provided for. So I feel like with the whole role of like she said, like, can a woman do it when a man is not there? And can a man do it when a woman's not there? Because I looked at my dad this weekend and I was like, so what would you do if mom wasn't here? Because my mom always does Tuki's hair, like my little sister Karen's hair. And my dad was like, oh, I'll just drop her off at your aunt's house. See, what you're not going to do, I'm here for you. Because if mom's not here, what you going to do? Or if all the women left this world, would you be able to take care of your little girls, is my thing, or your little boys, without a woman being there? Right.
That's what I was saying earlier about men can do women's jobs and you can do
that. But my daddy can't do that. He patted my head and told me to go on by my dad.
Does he expect that?
Exactly. You can swoop that bitch. I've let her start that next to me. You better burn that something.